Thanks, Barry. There's a lot of anticipation and excitement backstage as all the skaters are shaking off those pre-show jitters. As a matter of fact, I was just backstage with Scott Hamilton and Kurt Browning. They were joking around, having a lot of fun, keeping everyone loose. Paul Wiley likes to think about his music to gear himself up for the performance, and Christy Yamaguchi is in front of her hometown, and she wants to turn in a good performance for this audience. Now, all of the skaters are very special in their own way. They all have contrasting styles, but what makes them all so unique is the fact that they have such wonderful personalities, and they're so rehearsed and ready to go that those personalities will definitely show in the performances, a great bonus. Well, Barry, the ice feels really good right now, and I know the skaters are ready to go. I'm ready to go and sit back and watch what proves to be 2 hours of excellence in this holiday special. In fact, I hear the music coming up right now, so I'm going to come up and join you.
All right, thanks, Peter. We're at the Lawler Event Center here in Reno. Perfect place to spend a holiday evening. And the Lawler Event Center, a place that is host to a multitude of sporting events, all dressed up with some place to go during this season. Kind of a nutcracker theme here for the finest figure skaters in the world, and that, of course, a very familiar theme to all of us during this time of year. Peter Carruthers has joined me, and here we go, led by a hometown favorite.
And one of the most exciting times of the show, getting out in front of the audience for the first time, getting a feel for the ice. You know, all these skaters skate so well individually, but they're really remarkable together, too.
Christine Huff and Doug Ledre.
And always performing dynamic lifts and throws. A lot of fun to watch.
Rene Rocca and Gorsha Suhr.
What an interesting history behind these two, how they got together. We'll find out more about that later.
Tyler Cranston.
Well, Barry, if anybody has been in the sport a long time, it is Tyler Cranston. Think back in 1976, he won his bronze medal at the Olympics, and he's still skating to this day and doing very well.
Great innovator. Rosalind Sumners.
Also, to her credit, think back 1984, still skating, performing beautifully, and says she really just enjoys it.
Kurt Browning.
He's the four-time world champion. Very exciting to watch. Great height in the jumps and always entertains the crowd. Even though he's a Canadian citizen, he enjoys a lot of popularity here in the United States.
Here's Paul Wiley.
Well, I don't think you'll see anybody more passionate and energetic on the ice than Paul Wiley. He just loves it.
Gordieva and Grinkoff.
Well, Barry, if I were were to say anything about these two, it would definitely be that they are technically the most perfect pair skaters in the world today, and that's perfect evidence of it. Scott Hamilton. And if you were to call anyone the king of entertainment on the ice, you're looking at him right now. And finally, Christy Yamaguchi. Watching her at the Olympics in 1992 was definitely a thrill. But she's even better now. She's more professional, and as far as the hard work goes, there is not any skater that works harder than Christy Yamaguchi on the ice.
Festival on Ice.